I wonder what they did in life to deserve such a resting place.
The creature looks down from its perch, trembling. It from behind.
May Saravel te de larontu, Chamory.
The stream of noise cuts off abruptly. After a moment, you hear a jolting, lurching voice.
It wears the face of Zol. I suspected the Seven Lords won the war. What is this senseless braying? I speak of no beast king. I speak only of the king, the eternal king of creation, the king against whom the Seven Lords rebelled.
Deep within your soul, you feel your god stirring at the sound of the voice. You can feel its anger and fear swelling inside you. The creature leans forward to get a better look at you, clucking.
It seems to be a simple... I wonder...
She pulls back suddenly. The god within you reacts. Her emotions a cocktail of fury and fear. You hear her voice.
A terror, you...
The figure recalls...
Zol, still...
Silence! It is your king that has fallen. He and all the other...
And yet, here you stand. Small, weak, decaying. I will not even need the Aetiran.
You feel your god freeze at the...
Where?
Ha! Of... I hid it in the... Perhaps they... As for that monster, do not worry. The source shall not be wasted. It will carry me from this tomb. It will bring me freedom at last.
for.
I'm ready. Move, Quercus! Put some space between us and this lunatic!
The statue looms in the as the tears dampen.
Second time's a charm? Or have I asked too much of you?
Try as he might, Tarquin cannot hide a small flash of surprise.
Where did you hear that precisely? Never mind. The Aetirin is a children's fable, nothing more. Supposedly a wand with an infinite capacity for source. Pure nonsense, I assure you. Really? Well, perhaps that says more about the caliber of their intellect than anything else. Such a device would be a gross overconcentration of power. It could purge the entire world of all source. Luckily, the laws of the universe render such a thing impossible.
Warriors for hire, all seasoned in combat. They won't let you down.
Second time's a charm? Or have I asked too much of you? Second time's a charm?
Buying or selling? Capital. Good luck to you.
Among friends. Never forget it.
Not cold for the junkies.
What? Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your ton, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Glad to see you well. Anything more?
Hear ye! Hear ye! Bishop Alexander was slain.
Until later, then.
Back for a return visit, are you? Have at it. Got yourself situated. Yep.
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it. Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your ton, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
The spirit gives you a tortured glance. The spirit stares at her transparent hands, dazed. Here lies Natalie Bromhead. In death, she may find the peace that was denied her in life. The headless statue looms over you. The headless statue looms.
Won't budge.
A spirit sits behind the grand piano, her hands moving to and fro along the ivory keys.
O'er black and white, my fingers dart, as lost between worlds as I am. O'er globes they glide, o'er flats and sharps. Whither go they, Lord of Life? Direct them.
Her hands fall upon the keys like raindrops on a lake. Music ripples and rises like it did before the dragon's throne, thousands of years ago.
Blessed be Zara's memory. I pray you honor it.
The air buzzes with sauce here.
There you are, Godwoken. I'm eager to hear your good news.
The air buzzes with sauce here.
There you are, Godwoken. I'm eager to hear your good news. How marvelous.
Riker's lips tremble impatiently as his eyes dart to your pack.
Show it to me.
He considers you for a moment.
Very well.
Riker closes his eyes and spreads his arms, then begins to recite a vivid incantation.
I call to the souls of the dead. Your remains, the stone garden's eternal burden, descend from the hall. Surrender your source to the vessel before me.
Riker's voice grows even louder, drowning your words in a deluge of his own.
Swan and Rince, Crossley and Locke, Quincy, Keller, Harkwood, Haran, an essence yours no longer, souls and source come forth.
Your body convulses with Zorl Stiss's displeasure. Your head pounds, your bones ache. Riker's smile widens at the sight of your agony.
So this is how your path to divinity ends, is it? No matter. I've kept my promise. But there is another bargain I must fulfill. A shame it has to be this way. I was just getting fond of you.
Quick, there's not a moment to spare. She has him, and there's no telling what she'll do. The Black Ring which fled, and she has a Magister hostage. You know what they're capable of, don't you? Mihail is a good man. We need to help him. You'd believe that. Ah, you're of no use. No use. She's got him as a thrall, as a puppet. If you won't help, he's done for.
This is madness. The Black Ring, of course. The Ganglelegs have gone nuts for... Oh, go ahead. I don't...
You reach for your shears and give the sheep a good clipping. He gives a few bleats of appreciation.
There's my good deed for the day.
Wait for me, lads. You have to get her. She's too... She's Black Ring. Black...
Well? Have you found the cause of this aura? This shroud?
Please, don't...
Abomination.
to none.
Healing!
Huh?
Well, have you found the cause of this aura? This shroud?
She slinks forward until her face is mere inches from your own.
I owe you a debt. But I already know what you desire. And I intend to pay in full. Right now. Tell me, do you know exactly what I am? Excellent eye, my dear. You are correct. I am indeed a succubus. Love is my power. It enthralls those who lie with me and feeds me yet more power. My source abilities are linked to this aspect of me, and it is through this aspect that I must reward you.
You realize that her hand is caressing your arm. She gazes at you intently. Her eyes are oceans of violet. You could drown in them.
You have my word, though. I will not use my powers to make you my thrall. Just as I hope you won't use what I show you to become some sort of tyrant.
She grins devilishly and pulls you close.
Let's see what you're made of.
She kisses you. She devours. Suddenly she's all blinding light and come hither heat. You enter her heat, thrust upon thrust, until she scalds, and with a scream, her nails digging for blood, all becomes an echo of the primal soul, a burst of overwhelming white. Slowly the heat abates as she releases you with a kiss. Your vision swims back into view, Almira observing you with a knowing smile.
A lesson worth learning, was it not? Once you've caught your breath, I actually have another little request for you.
You have helped me to escape immediate danger, but I remain a fugitive from my old life and the promises I made to it. The Black Ring swear allegiance to a powerful being, the God King. This is not a mere oath of duty, this is the covenant. And those who accept it are bound to the God King. They are sworn. I am sworn. You have to understand, Lucien's death fog broke us. We were left defeated, leaderless. And then the God King started to speak to us. He offered victory, immortality, anything we desired in exchange for loyalty. How could we refuse? Once you are sworn, there is no escape. Your life is the God King's. Fail or betray him, and you are doomed. Unless you find a way to break the covenant. I discovered the existence of ancient implements called sworn breakers. They are rumored to be able to break any magical pact, including the covenant. And while enslaved by the magisters, I noticed a tablet in their excavation site in the Black Pits. It bore markings that looked very similar to how these sworn breakers were described to me.
She smiles, fixing those violet eyes upon you once again.
Will you retrieve it for me?
He is a god for the godless. A beacon for those who have no place in this world. He seeks to cast down the world of the Seven and build a new world with the Sworn at his side. The Black Ring flock to him after Lucien unleashed his death fog. The undead stand by him because he offers them a return to life. I don't know why the Voidwoken flock to him. But I want to be with Mahali. That is why the God King and I must part ways. That is why I need a sworn breaker. It is a promise that you cannot break, unless you want to end up broken yourself. Those who are sworn to it are bound to the God King, come victory or defeat. If you try to break the covenant unprepared, then you are sealing your own fate.
My, you are a special one, aren't you?
Well, that settles it then. I will join you, and I guarantee we will find use for each other in the future.
Either by, a black little birdie told me you've a ship along the shore. That is where we'll go, Enjoy a bit of sun while we wait for you to conclude your business along Reaper's Coast. In the meantime, have a little token as a thank you for all that you've done for me so far.
Incredible. I've never felt so alive.
You feel newfound powers of the Source course wildly through your body. Deep inside your soul, your god calls for you. It would be wise to meet with your god again by performing the Meister's Ritual, here or in Siva's vault.
Second time's a charm? Or have I...
Be on your way now, my dear. Perhaps we'll have matters to discuss again later.
I'll be glad when we leave Reaper's Coast behind. There's too many of my former comrades roaming around there.
Be on your way now, my dear. Perhaps we'll have matters to discuss again later.
Not much of a landlubber, but sometimes I get no choice in the matter.
Second time's a charm? Or have I asked too much of you?